to the laws who paid costs was handled by yours truly.
Raise up,
raise up,
ease up,
ease up,
raise up,
raise up,
ease up,
ease up,
raise up,
raise up,
ease up,
ease up.
Warriors come out to play.
Apparently extraordinary, don't compare minds to legendary, crossing thin lines, quoting my lines is purely entertainment. My same shit, I'll blow your back out, frame it. The same shit, will leave you on the floor brainless. Talking to me, best be making sense. Talking at me, prepare for ducking, only showering, cheering, you hollering. Trade slate stuff with talent, clean hands saying a violent. Fuck with, nothing to lose, ready to bust. Step with mine, I'm believer, luck, ill choice. You lost chance, better to dance with the devil in the darkness, the slow jams, the sick type, the real life, I'm concerned, play with life, you get burned, lack imagination, ill thoughts, use discretion, never holding out for my peeps, keeps protection, only way shells on you, breeze through, knock down obstacle, and clean phony asses off their pedestal, believe.
Coming right back at you, baby. If I ever fall in love again, next time the lady will be just like you.
The very first time that I saw your brown eyes, your lips said hello and I said hi.
Welcome back to the show, Stewies. Nothing says 1993 more than this song.
But to my satisfaction, maybe you more than just a face. And if I
ever fall
in love again, I will be sure that the lady is a friend.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Welcome back to the show, man. I'm laughing. I'm looking at this comment in the chat room. It says, from LD, habitual line stepper, yeah, side rod. If my mother-in-law knew how much I was riding her daughter's side out in 1993 to that song. If my mother-in-law knew how much I was riding her daughter's side out to that song in 1993. Oh. Lord have mercy. Please, please, Lord, don't let my mother find out. My mother-in-law find out. That's all right there. Classic side ride song. They should have, Shy, the name of that artist, if you're young, Greenhorn. Shy should have had, they should have gave me a credit on the damn album. We'd like to give a special thanks to Doug Stewart, who used this as the backdrop while he was riding the side out of his future wife, Miss Linda's daughter. God damn, just debauchery. But it was great. Oh, Lord. She would just look at me totally different. She would look at me in a totally different light. My mother-in-law loved me, man. We never had a problem from the very first time I met her, man. I mean, what's not to like? I'm a great man. I'm a great guy. And so me and my mother-in-law, she just thought I was the kindest, nicest person. Which is true. I don't want to get it twisted, which is true. But, you know, she think I'm just this wholesome country boy. And for the most part, that's accurate as well. But, Lord, if she knew the ride side, the side riding that me and her daughter did, man, my last year in college, man. I mean, it was like freaking rabbits on steroids. Yeah. Classic. Shouts out to the great Shy for that track. Wow. Yes, sir. We might can do a top five side ride songs. Like that Shy track is definitely on the list. The top five songs that you played in the background when you rode somebody's daughter's side out. Shy definitely makes the list. I'd have to think about that, man. All right, let's talk a little bit of entertainment. So today is March, or not March, April 13th, April 13th, 2017. So we went over Friday the 13th, 1990, Friday, April the 13th, 1990, which is pretty live, if I must say so myself. So celebrating a birthday today is the great Al Green. Why did I think Al Green was dead? I don't know. It bees like that sometime. But Al Green turned 71 years of age today. Happy birthday to the great Al Green. Yeah. And turning 24 today, Melvin Gordon, running back for the San Diego Chargers. He's a better back in the NFL than I thought he was going to be. And I guess I'm kind of biased against Wisconsin running backs because they've not fared too well in the NFL. The great Ron Dane, who stole the Heisman Trophy from my homeboy Joe Hamilton. Ron Dane fizzled out real fast. What was the kid named Monty Ball? I just read a story on him a couple of days ago. He had a real drinking problem. He was an alcoholic. Not in the NFL anymore. So I thought Melvin Gordon was going to follow in their footsteps, but he's, first couple of years, he's been balling out of control. Shouts out, happy birthday to the great Melvin Gordon, 24 years of age. Lorenzo Cain turns 31 years of age, player for the Kansas City Royals, turns 31, and that's it. I don't think we had any, I'm sorry, happy birthday to my man, K-Dub, his daughter's birthday is today. You thought I was going to forget, didn't you, Ninja? Happy birthday to K-Dub's daughter, Maya, who celebrates her birthday today. Happy birthday from the Doug Stewart Show and the Stewart Media and Entertainment Network. Happy birthday to K-Dub's daughter, his baby girl, who got an incredible voice, very talented. We played one of her tracks, if you're new to the show, during the breaks, singer here in ATL. So happy birthday to Maya. But obviously the big story today, man, in entertainment is the great Charlie Murphy died. He died in a New York City hospital. His manager said he'd been going through chemo. He famously co-starred on Chappelle's Show and some of Dave's most memorable skits, including the night that he partied with Prince. Which is classic, man. I mean, that skit, man, that skit was just, I'm trying to think, and maybe we could do a poll on this. Which one was better, the Prince skit or the Rick James skit? I think Rick James probably, because I think Rick James, the Rick James skit has really, I don't know, man. Gabe Blouses. I mean, they're almost as equally legendary. The Rick James skit, you know, Charlie Murphy, True Hollywood Stories, or whatever they called it, or the Prince thing, man, because the Prince thing was just so, oh, interesting, man. But he also co-wrote some of Eddie Murphy's movies. He co-starred in Are We There Yet, The Boondocks, and Black Jesus. That's right, I forgot about the big role that he had on Boondocks. He was one of the I don't even know how to describe it. There was two white guys that always, you know, tried to do all these knucklehead things on the Boondocks, and he was one of the voices. He recently toured with Cedric the Entertainer, Eddie Griffin, George Lopez, and D.L. Hughley. Did you know that his wife died in December of 2009 from cancer as well? Wow. That's tough, man. That's tough. Black Hollywood sent out condolences on Twitter from Gabrielle Union. Charlie Murphy was such a kind, sweet, funny man. Damn. Incredible talent, even better man. Rest in peace. From Chris Rock, he said, we just lost one of the funniest, most real brothers of all time. Charlie Murphy, rest in peace. Russell Simmons, sad to hear about the passing of Charlie Murphy. He was one funny, kind man, sending love and light to his family and friends. Wow. Rest in peace to the great Charlie Murphy, man, passing away at the age of 57. Bravo. Job well done. Job well done. You will be remembered. The great Charlie Murphy. Today is April 13th, once again, 2017. Today is National Make Lunch Count Day. I have no idea what the hell that means. Today is National Peach Cobbler Day. Love me some peach cobbler. Yes, Lord. Today is National Scrabble Day. What's the name of that damn Scrabble that was online? Words with Friends. God, boy, everybody was infatuated. We were hooked on Words with Friends for a couple of years. Do people still play Words with Friends? That was like 2010, 11 maybe? And everybody and mom was playing Words with Friends on Facebook. And today is National Thomas Jefferson Day. Man, damn Thomas Jefferson. Yeah. Damn Thomas Jefferson. Is he the one that had the kite? Or was that Ben Franklin? I think that was Ben Franklin. There's one more thing that I had on the great Charlie Murphy. Nah, that's it. We're going to go ahead and let him rest in peace, man. Rest in peace to the great Charlie Murphy. So back from 1993, the big movies in 1993, Cliffhanger. Coming in at number 10 was Cliffhanger. Sylvester Stallone, right? I think I saw that. I think it was okay. It was nothing to write home about. Number 9 was Schindler's List. I've never seen that movie. That movie gets all types of accolades. I don't think I've ever seen it. Number 8, The Pelican Brief. Don't remember it, but I remember it being a great movie. I do remember The Pelican Brief being a great movie. I don't remember the details about it. Number 7 was In the Line of Fire. Number 6 was Indecent Proposal. Number 5, Sleepless in Seattle. Number 4, The Firm. Number 3, The Fugitive. Number 2, Mrs. Doubtfire. And the number one movie of 1993 was Jurassic Park. Great movie. Great movie. Great movie, man. Them Jurassic Park movies were great. The new King Kong movie, I talked about it a couple weeks ago when I saw it. The new... what was it called? Escape from Kong Island or whatever. Me and old lady saw it on $5 Tuesday. And that movie kind of reminds you of, I guess they used some of the CGI technology or whatever that they did in Jurassic Park. But that movie kind of felt a little Jurassic Park-y. but it was a damn good movie, the new King Kong movie. If you haven't seen it, go on out and check it out. Let me read some messages in the chat room on Spreaker.com.